First question, how many of you use or did use React Native Router Flux? Oh, nice. What about React Navigation? Sorry. Okay. Sorry, it's my first talk ever. So, yeah. Okay, so what is RNRF, React Native Router Flux? It's a declarative React Native Router. What? One more navigation solution. Why we need that? Okay, here is motivation. Wrap best existing navigation library, fill the gaps, and hide underlying navigation implementation complexity. First of all, it was ...2015, when I created that library. It was just single navigation component. And I know I like idea of React Native, but navigation was very frustrated because it was not declarative like React. So I created navigation with stable and easy API, and my goal was to create something similar to iOS storyboards. When you see everything of logic of your app in one place. I choose JSX because it's like React style. It just sorry for small fonts because otherwise I was not able to feel React navigation. Yeah, and first snippet contains much more logic. We will discuss it later. So let's start to compare API. React Native Router Flux just uses these props, not like these props navigation state params. Actually, I think it's correct approach because props navigation state params is like encapsulation is against encapsulation principle, because components should not know anything about your navigation solution. They just need to use props. It is about calls to navigate. Okay, here is actions, like some singleton class that could be used to call some new page. Later we discuss new syntax for latest version that looks even better because it does not use singleton. Singleton has own limitation and it could be not good for some use cases. For example, for testing separate components. Here it is, advanced API. When you define scenes, it's like a feature I implemented 2 days ago when created this presentation. When you can define your all transition for your scene and define, on login, on sign up, on forgot password. This way you will see all your transition. And you should not dip into component and see, here is sign up, okay? And within the component, you can just use these props on sign up with button. So it's like, okay, wrong screen. One more thing is define scene action type once. For example, if you need some reset action or something like that, you can define it within your router, not within, not pass params every time. It's like dry principle. Again, navbar customization. It's just less code for title, back buttons, drawer image and styling, and it allows you to inherit all your properties, like in tree. So you define it once and don't declare anywhere else. Again, dry principle. So fill in the gaps. It's like additional functionality that misses React navigation, like replace action, avoid double taps is still open tickets, so I decided to implement it within React Native Router Flux, pop to navigation action, and many others. I don't have time to list of all of them. Also, you can access current state from anywhere using Singleton or just this props route name. You can clone scenes. For example, typical UI is user profile that could live in any stack in your app. So you can define it just once, and it will be it can be used automatically. With React navigation, you should insert it in any stack. And two additional custom navigators, Lightbox and Overlay. What is it? Lightbox is used to create some on-screen animation, like pop-ups, error alerts, something like that. And Overlay, custom navigator, allows you to define some overlays, like background images, like message bar. You know, maybe you used message bar and you need to define it globally for your app, so you can do it with overlay. And also, a lot of people asked me how to access a component instance from navigation bar, because it could be very useful. For example, you are typing something and you need to change color of navigation bar, right navigation button, from gray to disable it to enable it, and so on. So you can again access actions refs login and use it its state. And Mobix Redux integration, it's already done. You could pass your own state and or reducer to the router. It allows you control your state and override navigation logic if necessary. Also, you can call your transition like you did with React navigation. For Mobix, maybe for Redux it could be useful as well. You can pass wrap by property, like global property, and it will be applied to all navbar buttons as well. This way you can make dynamic buttons out of the box. And okay, one feature I want to explain is new way of latest version, typical authentication. A lot of people have troubles with it. For example, here is some typical flaw when you need to load data from local storage and decide what to screen to display, login or not login, display to if it is stored credentials, you need to authenticate. After that, to verify if this user fill it all data or not, to redirect them to sign up screen. So its flaw is not trivial, and a lot of problems with many people use component did mount for that, and I don't like that approach because it contradicts. It could be considered as anti-pattern because you are mixing UI and your business logic when you. So developers are using Redux for that and implementing custom reducers to maintain that logic. If it's too complex, you can use RR. This component, when you describe like logical states without components, you see do check, do auth, do verify. It's implemented like children of Lightbox, because those states should not do any animation or any navigation, so we skip component for them. We describe action that should be executed on enter, and success, failure properties, what to do next. This way, we have like state machine. So, future directions. It's completely separate road definition from UI, because unfortunately, React Navigation now did very good job about separation, but not completely, because you cannot create just state map, road map, without requiring defining all navigators that as UI. And support more rendering engines, native navigation, Airbnb navigation. And automatic validation of your road and map. With that syntax, new syntax, you can detect cycles, mistype a transition on user screens, and so on. So, and finally, we can generate UML diagrams. It's not implemented yet, but probably could be implemented from ZJSX. So you don't need to create them manually and support. Example of that app with that code snippet here. And thank you very much for listening.